morning, children. This is your English class. I am Durga Behra from SSER Railway Higher Secondary Number 1. And I hope you all present in your English class. Children, always should be ready and alert with your books and copy. I have some question for you. Today, you all make sure yourself by these questions. But these questions will be little bit different from your exercise. So today you all pay attention for these questions and attempt all questions. But we have one exercise question from your chapter. I take only 3 questions and rest 2 you do yourself and practice at home. Now we go to our exercise question. Then after you will ready with your books and copy, children. You take one note copy, pen, and ready to attempt all questions. And make sure yourself how much you know and learn about your chapter. If you are incorrect for the any questions, again you revise and practice. So children, we revise, but before that we do one exercise. Now we go to one exercise from your chapter also. Yes, we have one question. Circle. We have one exercise question. Circle the odd one out. Children, this question means you have set of words, and from the set of words you have one word is different from the other. Means you choose and find that word which does not go with others. Means you make sure yourself which type of words. At first you confirm which type of word. Yes, children. And I have given one clue also. Your first set of words you have vegetable. It means you have turnip, potato. You write the words, children. Tomato, sunflower, brinjal, and we have one clue also for this question. You see, at first we do this exercise and after you will ready for your mock test. Children, here you see we have set of words, and again I repeat this words. I want to repeat: turnip, potato, tomato, sunflower, brinjal. Here you can see we have some words, but you see here we have the same words related from the vegetable, but one is not go with others. What is the word? You guess, children. Again you repeat and guess the word. Here again I repeat: turnip, potato, tomato, sunflower, brinjal. Yes, from this word one is not go with other. One word. I think all you guess the sunflower. Yes, this sunflower is not go with others, where all are vegetables. All you know, children, how you check your answer, means how you choose and find which word is different from other, which is odd from others. Now we have our second question. From this way we have second ones. We have some trees name. You see, neem, mango, neem, mango, peepal, snack, apple. Here we have clue, given the clue is trees. Means from this word you choose the tree's name, but one is not with the trees, which is not match like trees. Again you repeat all these words, children. What we get from this word? At first we repeat neem, mango, people, snack, apple. You can see here we have set of words: neem, mango, people, snack and apple. Here children, four words are name of tree and one is different from others. You guess? I think you try to guess. One is our snack, means this word is different from others. Why you know? Because snack is a reptile. You know about reptile which move or run on ground with the help of their body, means they crawl on ground. So here we have set of trees, but one is different. Which is different? All you know. Now we go to our next word. Yes, we have third set of words here. Set. Yes, our word is first rose, lily, sunflower, lotus, and the last is cauliflower. Here children, we have the next one is rose, lily, sunflower, lotus, cauliflower. Here we have the clue, children. What is the clue? Here we have flowers. We have flowers in the set of words. We have the name of flower, but which one is not match with the others? What is the word? What is the word? You can guess. Yes, you try to guess, children. You try to guess which is the word. Yes, here again you repeat these words. At first you have rose, second lily, sunflower, lotus, cauliflower. Here you know, children, this four words is go with the flowers, means this four word is the name of flower, but one is here a vegetable. Yes, you guess which one is so to the vegetable, children. Here cauliflower is a vegetable, so we have our or here cauliflower, means set of words rose, lily, sunflower, lotus and cauliflower. What is our or? Yes, here the set of words, children, we have all the words are flowers, but one is a vegetable. Which one is a vegetable? All you know, cauliflower. From this way you check your other question, children, from your exercise. Now you check your question and note down from your book. We go to ready for the question, children. Next over for the mock test. Yes, I rub the questions. You will be ready for your test question, mock test, and attempt all questions by yourself and revise your chapter. How much you are right? Yes, children, by this question, you check and observe yourself how much you learn from this chapter. Suppose if you are get the incorrect answer, again you check and revise. Okay, so you will be ready for the mock test question. We have some questions for you. You are ready? Yes, you ready with your notebook and pen, children? And pay attention for the question, because these questions are little bit different from your book exercise question. Yes, we have mock test. At first you put the date and write mock test. You write mock test, chapter, the enormous turnip, and write the date. Put the date, and your first question is, you have multiple choice question, children. By this question, you check yourself, your knowledge about this chapter. Our first question is, what the old man did with the turnip seeds? All you note down very carefully. You note down, children. You note down your question. What the old man did with the turnip seed? You have options. At first, you have option decorated. Decorated them. Decorated them. Your first option. Decorated them. Your second option is planted. Planted them. And third one is sold them. Here, little bit different from your exercise question. What the old man did with the turnip seed? Now, you have your second question. Note down all the questions, children. One by one, you note down all the questions. Question number two, the old man. The old man could not pull up the turnip because means you find out the reason. You find out the reason. The old man could not pull up the turnip because you have your first option. It was very big. And the second option B. The soil was very dry. Yes. I know, children, this options are little bit different from your exercise. So carefully you read. He was very tired. I give few minutes for the all questions. So try to write first. Okay, I am watching you. You attend all questions, children, from yourself. I am watching you. How you complete your answer. So nicely you read at first all the questions one by one and choose one answer. Then I will give you all the answer. Again you check and revise your answer. Your first question, what the old man did with the turnip seeds. What the old man did with the turnip seed. It means old man ne turnip seed ke saath kya kiya? Decorated them, planted them, sold them. And the next question, the old man could not pull up the turnip because we have three reasons. At first, A, it was very big. Second one is the soil was very dry. And third one is he was very tired. Yes, I know you think the right answer. The answer is very easy, children. I give you few times for all the questions. So write first. and think about the question. I give you few times for all questions, children. So nicely you write all the options. Clearly you write all the answers and put right mark which is correct. Right, first children, we have other question also. Right, first, if you write question number one, I read this questions. Will you write the question number one? From this question, children, you again revise your knowledge, how much you learn from this chapter. Okay, yes, our third question is question number three. From this story, you guess who came first, who came first to help the old man, who helped old man. All you know, children, how many person to come to help the old man, but in this question you guess one who is come first, a boy B, a girl C, an old lady. Who came first to help old man? You finish your question number two, children. All you write your second question. May I write the second question, children? Yes, you continue write all the questions and which are correct you take mark. Then after when we have complete all the questions, again check one by one. Okay, question number four. Which word means the same as enormous? Means you guess the meanings of the enormous. Which word means the same as enormous? You have the options: tiny, B, large, C, strong. Yes, children, I give you few minutes for the question, for the question number three and question number five, question number four. Your question number three is, who came first to help the man? Old man, who came first? All you know, when you know the story, children, if you know the story, you guess the right answer. You think and guess the right answer, which is correct from the three options: a boy, a girl, an old lady. Here, who came first? Here, little bit change from your exercise question, children. So, pay attention for it. You have the options, a boy, a girl, an old lady. And question number four, which word means the same? Means you guess the meaning here. Your first word is tiny, B is large, and C is strong. Which go with the same meaning like enormous? Do fast, children. I know all you have options for the all questions. Right first. If you write third question, may I rub the third question, children? If you finish third question, I give you next question, question number 5. All the question is revised from your story. So again you revise your story from these questions and nicely you tick mark which are correct. Question number five. How many you can write how many people finished to pull up the turnip. Yes, you guessed the number of pupils here. Who helped the old man for pull up the turnip? You have option 1 pupil. You have option, children. First option is 1. Second, 3, and the last option is 4. How many people finished to pull up the turnip? How many people has to the old man? And all you know, this question is little bit different. How many people finished to pull up the turnip? Here the question is little bit different from your exercise. It means all you know who helped the old man, but here you have the option how many people finished to pull up the turnip. Means you count all the person who finished to pull up the turnip. So children, pay attention for this question. This question is little bit different from your exercise. Here I am writing here how many people finished to pull up the turnip. So guess the answer. Finished means the work is complete. Means how many pupils? All you know this story, and how many pupils finished? The work is finished by the pupil. You count how many pupils. Yes? If you write the question number 4, you write the next question, children. So easy for you. These are the multiple choice question. You tick mark only the correct answer, on the correct answer. Here your next question. Guess the answer. Question number 6. At last, where was turnip? Where was turnip? At last, where was turnip? Yes, your options are up on the ground. Second one is underwater. And third is in the sky. At last, where was turnip? Here you have options: upon the ground, underwater, in the sky. Yes, children, you guess. Up on the ground, underwater, or in the sky. Choose your right option, children. I know you know your story. Very easily you guess your answer. So write fast. You choose only right answer. Don't write your option, children. Only choose your right answer, which is correct from 3 options. I am watching all of you. Do fast. At last, where was turnip? Your first option: upon the ground, underwater, in the sky. And question number 5. Here you guess the pupils. How many pupils finished to pull the turnip? Here, children, in all the questions, little bit different from your exercise. So pay attention for all questions and choose the option which are correct. You finish your question, children? Question number 5. All you finish your question number 5. How many people finished to pull the turnip? I think you know the right answers. Yes? You all finished the question number 5, children? All you finished your question number 5, children? Only choose the right answer. At first you write your question, then choose the right option. I write the next question, children. Question number 7. You revise your story first to end from these questions. Okay, question number seven. Who at the enormous turnip? You have three options. The old man and old woman. Second option, the boy and the girl. And your third option, all of them. Who at the enormous turnip? You have first option, choose the first option. The old man and old woman, the boy and the girl, and see all of them. Means, who all present for the turnip? Yes. Our last question, children. You finished your question number 6? All you finished your question number 6, children? Yes. I wrap these questions and write the next question. Question number 8. Question number 8. Question number 8. And one by one, again we check all the answer. Yes, question number 8. Who came last? Who came last to help? Who came last to help? Here you have options. The old woman, B, the boy, and your last option, the girl. Children, this is your last question. Carefully read and choose the right option. Who came last to help? Who came last to help? The old woman, the boy, the girl. And all you know which work they do together. In this chapter, they done one work together. But here, who came last to help? Who came last to help? You have options. The old woman, the boy and the girl. All you know who came first and who came last to help. You have option the old woman, the boy, the girl. And question number 7, you get the answer, who ate the enormous turnip? You have the options, the old man and woman, the boy and the girl, and third is all of them. You choose one is correct. I give you few minutes, children. Guess first which is correct. Only write the correct answer, children. At first you write your question, then choose your right answer. Only right answer. You choose only right answer. Suppose you have question, who ate the enormous turnip? You write, if one is correct, then you write only correct answer. One is correct. Only write the correct answer. Then we will check our answer one by one. I hope, children, you write fast. Write fast and finish your questions. All you write fast, children. Do fast. Write song. Who came last to help? Now, children, you write fast and get ready for the answer. Yes. You want to know the correct answer, children? All you know? You want to know the correct answer? So ready for your answer. All you finish your question, children? All you finish? Who ate the enormous turnip? Choose only correct answer. Which one is correct? Only choose your correct answer. Yes. Now, children, you check your answer one by one. I give the correct answer one by one. You choose your right answer. from your notebook. You choose your right answer. Okay, one by one you check your answer, how much you are give correct answer. Okay. Yes. Yes. Your first question was, what the old man did with Tony's seat? You have three options. Your right option is planted them. Your right option is planted them. And two, the old man could not pull up the turnip because what is the reason, children? It was very big. It was very big. I hope you choose your right answer. Question number third, who came first to help old man? All you know, children, you have little bit change here. The old woman in the old woman, place of old woman, I write an old lady. Then this is your correct answer. An old lady. Question number four. Question number four, children. Which word means the same as enormous? Since you choose the right meaning here, large. Which gives the correct meaning? Large. And question number five. How many persons finished to pull up the turnip? Here, children, you add the old man also. Means how many person finish, how many people finish the work. Means you have the option four is correct. Four persons. Question number six. At last, where was Tani? You see, where was Tani, children? Upon the ground, under water, in the sky. You have three options. Which is correct here? Yes, on the ground. Yes, you're right. Up. On the ground. Now you check your seven number. Who ate? In this, you have correct option, all of them. All of them. And your last question, who came last to help? Yes, all you know, the girl. The girl. If you give correct answer, children, you give yourself one star and very good. You give yourself a star and very good. Children, by this question, you again revise all the story from first to end and do your other exercise from this chapter. Next, you will ready for the new chapter. So, good day, children. Stay healthy.